Today, a young man on acid realized that all matter is merely energy condensed to a slow vibration, that we are all one consciousness experiencing itself subjectively. There is no such thing as death. Life is only a dream, and we're the imagination of ourselves. Here's Tom with the weather.
And now neuroscience has told us in the unfolding of our lives, only 5% of our life is controlled by our conscious mind, and 95% of the time controlled by the subconscious with programs from other people that were installed in there. And the problem is, it means when those programs are playing, we don't see them.
The question is, are we leading conscious or unconscious lives?
Get at me, Wolf!
Ooh. Yeah! Ooh.
Shake dreams from your hair, my pretty child, my sweet friend. Choose the day and choose the sign of your day, the day's energy. First thing you see. A vast radiant beach and cool, cool moon. Couples naked race down by its quiet side. And we laugh like soft, mad children, smug in the woolly cotton grains of infancy. The music and voices are all around us.
When you start to come across this information, it's like your kind of mind opens and you start to see, hey, what you hadn't seen before.
Choose, they croon, the ancient ones, the time has come again. Choose now, they croon, beneath the moon, beside an ancient lake. Enter again the sweet forest, enter the hot dream, come with us. Everything is broken up in dances.
We've lost our traditional roots and don't know about ritual. The dragon dances and the ghost dances of the Native American Indians, what do you think that was all about? The shamans of the world, when they do their rituals, they're doing that. Their work, harmonically through dances, is to strengthen the immune system of the earth.
So most people don't even understand how easily we're influenced by our environment. Every person that we encounter, every single situation that we're faced with, every little word that's said on television may not seem too influential to our conscious mind, but your unconscious is designed specifically to let every environmental signal influence you without your awareness.
Indians scattered on dawn's highway bleeding, ghosts crowd the young child's fragile eggshell mind. We have assembled inside this ancient and insane theater to propagate our lust for life and flee the swarming wisdom of the streets. The barns are stormed, the windows kept, and only one of all the rest to dance and save us with the divine mockery of words, music, and flame's temperament. Great creator of being, grant us one more hour to perform our art and perfect our lives. We need great golden copulations. When the true king's murderers are allowed to roam free, 1,000 magicians arise in the land. Where are the feasts we were promised?
And the skeptics will sit there and say, consciousness? Archetypes? Astrology? No. We create things with our hands, not our minds. Archetypes aren't physical. They can't influence me. But when you think of the fact that we're only conscious of this small little fraction of our behavior, what we don't realize is that entire countries, entire civilizations that think they're free and independent, but are unconsciously too afraid to be free and independent, they will beg to be governed.